Okay, so we're going to do a KSP problem with copper hydroxide. This is copper 2 hydroxide, so it's got a plus 2 charge, so I know this is its formula. And it's dissolving. I want to know about its molar solubility. This seems like it ought to be a pretty straightforward molar solubility problem. We're going to see that indeed it is not, and we're going to see why it is not. Let's treat it as if it were a straightforward problem. In a straightforward problem, we would put some here. We put 0 here and 0 here, saying, okay, we haven't made any of this yet. We dissolve some. We produce an S here. We produce a 2S there. So this gives me some of this, S of this, and 2S of this. All right, so far, that is a straightforward KSP problem where you're trying to determine the molar solubility. Then you write your expression. KSP is equal to the copper concentration times the hydroxide concentration. Okay, and my pen is not writing as well as I should like, so let's see what I can do to it here. Right, baby. Yeah, better. All right, so you can't see my brackets too well. And that's squared. Okay, so what did we do next? We took our KSP value. Our KSP value was 2.2 times 10 to the minus 20. That's a very tiny value. My copper was S, and my hydroxide was 2S, and that was squared. Now, let's go back up here. Is this really zero? We often put a zero there, okay? But this is sitting in water. So what this really is 1 times 10 to the minus 7. What we're assuming is that that is so small that we can ignore that there's any at all. Let's see if this really works. When we solve for S, 2.2 times 10 to the minus 10 is equal to 4S cubed. We divide both sides by 4, okay? And then we take the cube root of it. Let's see if I've got that number sitting here for me to consider. I gotta make sense of my notes. Yes, yes. No. Okay, so I divide both sides by 4. That gets the 4 over here. Then I took the cube root. Once I divided by 4, I took a cube root, and this gave me an S value equal to 2.2 times 10 to the minus 7. And 2S would be twice that number, right? It'd be 4.4 times 10 to the minus 7. All right, so let's go back up to this little assumption we made. We assumed that you didn't have any hydroxide to begin with, and this is zero. But that's not true. There is 1 times 10 to the minus 7 really sitting there in reality. And our 2S, you're adding something that's on the order of magnitude, and it makes a big difference in the value of the molar solubility. We can't make that assumption, okay? This is only because that's a OH minus ion for this. So we couldn't assume with it such a small that this is not as negligible compared to the amount that you produce. So let's get rid of that assumption and put a 1 times 10 to the minus 7 in here. So I'm going to put 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7, and this becomes 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 plus 2s instead of just 2s. So then I come down here and I say, all right, well, I could make that assumption. Now let's see what we have. 2.2 times 10 to the minus 20 is equal to S. That's good. We have 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 plus 2S, and that is cubed. Now we might say, well, we couldn't assume that this was zero. Maybe we could assume that this was zero. Now, this thing is so tiny, but this is super tiny. And when you solve for S, you can't make that assumption. Now, you could try it, okay? Let's try it. Let's assume that we can ignore this, that 2S is much, much smaller than 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7. Then it gets to be easy to solve. We have 2.2 times 10 to the minus 20 is equal to S times 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 cubed. And when you do that work and you come up with the S value, you end up with an S value of 5.2 times 10 to the minus 6. That's what S is. So 2S, our assumption was that this was much, much, that 2S was much, much smaller, so I could ignore it. 2S is 10.4 times 10 to the minus 6, or 1.04 times 10 to the minus 5. Well, that ain't smaller than it at all. That was a terrible assumption. So you can't do this problem. We got issues, as we would say, because you end up having to do a cubic. And we're not going to make you do that, solve for it. We don't give you a graphing calculator to come up with a value. So the moral to the story in this problem is, if you've got hydroxide up here, you can't give it a zero, all right? It's got some significance because these values are so small, they're going to contribute on the magnitude of that value to solve the problem. So what we can do is then say, all right, we can't do it straight up, but maybe we can do it if we have it in a buffered solution. So part B is in a buffered solution of base, and the other one is in a buffered solution of an acid. We'll do those next.